Hi friends, today we will see the physiological changes during the pregnancy. An average duration of a pregnancy is 280 days or 40 weeks, that is 10 lunar months from the first day of last menstrual period. The duration also divided into three equal parts or trimesters of slightly more than 13 weeks or a 3 calendar months. The estimated date of confinement, EDC, or date or delivery, or EDD, estimated date of delivery, can be calculated by Nagler's rule. The rule is by calculating 9 months plus 7 days from the first day of last menstrual period. Another method of calculation of EDC is by McDonald's rule, but it can be done only after 24 weeks of gestation. That is, the fundal height measurement will correspond to the week of gestation plus or minus 2 weeks. The physiological changes which happens to genital organs. The first one is vulva. The vulva become edematous, superficial varicosities in multiparous women, and also the vaginal wall becomes hypertrophied, edematous and more vascular. Secretions from become copious, thin, curdy white. pH more acidic due to conversion of glycogen to lactic acid by lactobacillus acidophilus. This is because of the high estrogen level present in the maternal body. The acidic pH will prevent the multiplication of microorganisms. It is a physiological method of preventing infection during pregnancy. Because of the lactobacillus acidophilus, the glycogen component is converted to the lactic acid. So the acid pH, it will prevent the multiplication of the microorganism. But disadvantage is that the glycogen rich environment is more suitable for a fungal infection. Jacquemus sign. It is a bluish discoloration of the vagina due to increased blood supply to that particular area. Leucorrhea. Leucorrhea is the white or slightly grey mucoid discharge from the vagina because of the many exfoliated vaginal epithelial cells caused by the hyperplasia of the normal pregnancy. The mucus fills the endocervical canal, resulting in the formation of a mucus plug. The mucus plug is known as operculum. This operculum acts as a barrier against bacterial infections invasion during pregnancy. Ovaries. Progesterone is known as a hormone of pregnancy. It must be present in adequate amount to sustain the pregnancy. So many of the changes which take place in the maternal body is because of two hormones. One is the progesterone and another one is the estrogen. But progesterone is known as the hormone of pregnancy. The progesterone suppress contraction and prevent the tissue rejection of the fetus. And also the corpus luteum secretes progesterone till 10 to 12th week, till the placenta is fully developed and capable of producing adequate progesterone for the body. Ovulation ceases during the pregnancy because high circulating estrogen and progesterone inhibit follicle stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone. The major changes which happen to the uterus. Decidua. Endometrium of the pregnancy is known as, during the pregnancy is known as decidua. Uterus have three layers, the endometrium, the muscle layer myometrium, and the peritoneal layer is known as the perimetrium. The internal layer is the endometrium. Endometrium during pregnancy is known as decidua. Myometrium is the muscle layer. Estrogen and progesterone will make the decidua to thicker, richer and more vascular at fundus and in the upper body of the uterus, which is the usual site for implantation. The uterus increases in the weight. The pre-pregnant weight of the uterus is only 60 gram, but at the time of term or during the delivery, the weight of the uterus is nearly 1000 gram or 1 kg. The size, pre-pregnant uterus size is only 7.5 into 5 into 2.5 centimeter. That becomes to 30 cm into 23 cm into 20 cm. That means 30 cm in the length, 23 in the width, and 20 cm is the thickness of the uterus. Estrogen causes the growth of uterine muscles. That means the uterine muscles undergo hypertrophy as well as hyperplasia and some amount of stretching beyond 20 weeks. The uterus is able to stretch because progesterone is also cause this phenomena, because the main function of the one of the function of the progesterone is the smooth muscle relaxation. There are four parts of the uterus. The first is the fundus. Fundus means the uppermost area of the uterus. The enlargement and thickening is more at the fundus. Second, body. Body otherwise known as corpus. It is the main portions between the fundus and the cervix. Isthmus or neck of the lower uterine segment. And the final part is the cervix. It is supravaginal. That means the portions that extend inside the uterus contain inner walls and vagina. The muscle layers, the middle layer is the myometrium. Myometrium is known as the muscle layer. There is three type of muscles. The outer muscle is the longitudinal, which is arranged in a longitudinal. The inner muscle is arranged in a circular way, which involved in the stretching of the lower uterine segment and cervix during labor. But the middle layer, which is the oblique layer, the muscle is arranged in a oblique or the crisscross fashion. That means one muscle go inside the other muscle, that is act as a living ligature. Living ligature means at the time of delivery, when these blood vessels go inside through this one muscle to the other muscle, when it is contract, the blood vessels also will be contracting. So there will be a minimum chance of bleeding. That means the amount of blood which comes out of the uterus will be reduced when the uterus is contracting. So this is known as a living ligature. Blood supply to the uterus. The blood supplies to the uterus increase to meet the growth of the growing fetus as well as the uterus. There are 450 to 650 ml of blood which go at a minute, it will go into the uterus. The low maternal arterial pressure, contraction of the uterus and supine position are the three factors which is known to reduce the blood flow. Doppler ultrasound done to find out the uterine blood flow, especially in pregnancies associated with decreased fetal blood flow like PIH, pregnancy induced hypertension, intrauterine growth retardation, diabetes mellitus and multiple gestation. Estrogen causes growth of new blood vessels. Braxton Hicks contractions. They are the painless uterine contraction felt after 4th month. It facilitates uterine blood flow through the intervilled space of the placenta, thereby promote oxygen delivery to the fetus. Braxton Hicks, the person who discovered this type of contractions. It is the infrequent, spasmodic and painless contraction. The patient will not be aware of this contraction at many times. During the contraction, complete closure of the uterine veins and partial occlusion of the arteries in relation to intervillous space resulting in the stagnation of blood. Changes in the uterine shape. At 12th week, the uterus comes out of the pelvis. Till 12th week, uterus is a pelvic organ. After 12th week, the uterus comes out of the pelvis and become an abdominal organ. At 16th week, the uterus midway between symphysis pubis and the umbilicus. At 24th week, the uterus reaches at the level of the umbilicus. At 28th week, the uterus reaches midway between symphysis sternum and umbilicus. At 36th week, it reaches the symphysis sternum. 40th week, it will be 4 finger breadth below the symphysis sternum. Why it is below the symphysis sternum? After 36 weeks, the physiological phenomena like lightening takes place. That means the presenting part will descend down into the pelvis. So there will be a the presenting part will be come down into the pelvis, so there will be the fundus will be coming down. Fundus enlarges more than the body. This is the fundal height measurements. Cervix acts as an effective barrier against infection, and also it retains pregnancy. Progesterone, it is an endocervical cell secrete mucus thicker and viscous during pregnancy, and it forms the a cervical plaque operculum, which we have seen earlier and which provide protection from the infection. Length of the cervix, there will be no change which takes place during the length of the pregnancy. It will be 2.5 cm throughout the pregnancy. Softening of the cervical tip, it is known as a Goodell sign, which can be seen by at 6th week due to increase in vascularity, hypertrophy and hyperplasia of the cells. Increase the water content and vascularity of the area. Obvious change in color and consistency resulting in the bluish purple color extend up to vagina and labia, which is known as a Chadwick signs. Before pregnancy, cervix consistency similar to the tip of the nose, and during pregnancy it is the same as that of the lip. The cervical softening is known as the Goodell sign. Changes in the cardiovascular system. The maternal adjustment to pregnancy involves extensive changes in the cardiovascular system. The first organ which undergoes the heart, the size will be increased. It is to compensate with the increasing in the workload. The cardiac output start to increase from the 5th week and reaches maximum by 30 to 34 weeks and return to a pre-labor values by 1 hour following the delivery and to the pre-pregnant level by another 4 weeks. Blood pressure. Systemic vascular resistance decreases due to smooth muscle relaxation. Even though the cardiac output increases, the workload of the heart increases, the blood volume increases, the blood pressure will not, have no change in the blood pressure. It is because there will be a smooth muscle relaxation of the because of the progesterone, hormone progesterone, the blood vessels are the smooth muscles, so it will be relaxed and there will not be no change of the blood pressure during pregnancy. But there is another condition which can happen during pregnancy is the supine hypotension syndrome. That means during the late pregnancy, the patient is in a supine position for a long period of time, the gravid uterus will compress the inferior vena cava, which takes the impure blood from the lower extremity. So there will be a decrease in the decrease in the venous return. That will lead to decrease in the cardiac output, and this will lead to hypotension, tachycardia and syncope. That is why during the late pregnancy we have to advise the patient not to have supine position for a long period of time, because this may lead to the decrease in venous return, thereby decrease in the cardiac output, thereby it lead to hypotension, tachycardia and syncope, and this condition is known as supine hypotension syndrome. Cardiac output is lowest in sitting or supine position, highest in knee, chest or lateral position. The cardiac output increases due to the increase in the blood volume to meet the additional oxygen demand. Increase in the cardiac output will increase in the stroke volume and heart rate up to 15 beats per minute. A normal heart will be able to cope up with this increase in the cardiac output. But a diseased heart or a patient is already having any cardiac problem will not be able to compensate with this, and they may develop cardiac failure during the pregnancy. The uterine blood flow is increased from 50 ml per minute to 750 ml per minute at term. The blood flow to the skin and mucous membrane reaches the maximum by 500 ml per minute by 36th week. Heat sensation, sweating or stuffy nose are usually complained due to the increased blood flow to the skin. Breast changes. Fullness, increased sensitivity, tingling, heaviness due to increase in the estrogen and progesterone. The size will be increased due to hypertrophy and proliferation of the ducts. The nipple become larger, erectile and deeply pigmented. The sebaceous glands become hypertrophied and are called as Montgomery tubercles. They are placed around the nipples and secretions have protective role in keeping the nipple and areola moist and healthy for breastfeeding. The outer zone is less marked and irregular pigmented area appears in second trimester and is called the secondary areola. Estrogen stimulates the growth of mammary ductal tissue and progesterone promotes the growth of lobes, lobules and alveoli. Although development of the mammary gland is completed by the mid-pregnancy, the lactation is inhibited by high estrogen level. Secretion, that is the colostrum, which is yellow in color, can be squeezed out of the breast from the second trimester. The presence of a CSM, the presence of demonstration of secretion of a from the breast of a woman who has never been lactated is an important sign of pregnancy. The cutaneous changes, otherwise known as the skin changes, due to the melanocyte stimulating hormone which increases during pregnancy. All the cutaneous changes are due to because of the increased melanocyte hormone which increase during the pregnancy. Face, chalasma or chalasma gravidarum or pregnancy mass, the extreme form of pigmentation around the cheek, forehead and around the eyes. Breast changes we have already seen. In the abdomen there is linea nigra. It is the brownish black pigmented area from symphysis pubis to the umbilicus, or sometimes it may extend up to sternum. It is due to the separation of underlying connective tissue of the skin. Stria gravidarum, initially it is pink but after delivery they become glistering white appearance called stria albicans. The increased blood supply to the skin lead to sweating. The stria represents the scar tissue in a deeper layer of the skin. Angiomas refer to vascular spirals. It occurs as a result of elevated levels of circulating progesterone. They disappear after delivery. Palmar erythema are due to increased estrogen level. Gum hypertrophy may occur. And nail growth may be accelerated during the pregnancy. Increased blood flow to the skin may cause increased perspiration. These are the changes of the cutaneous changes which happens during a pregnancy. Weight gain. Total weight gain during the pregnancy is considerably, it is 11 to 12 kg. And the first trimester it is considered as 1 kg. And the second trimester it is considered as 5 kg. And third trimester also it is considered as 5 kg. If a person who has a normal BMI, that is between 20 to 26, the average weight gain during pregnancy can be between 11 to 16 kg. But a person who have a BMI that is more than normal, that is about 29, she is advised to gain only up to 7 kg of weight. But a person who has a low BMI, that is less than 19, she can gain up to 18 kg. Why the weight checking is so important? It is because of the rapid weight gain. If the person is having a rapid weight gain, it may be an indicative of some pathological conditions like pregnancy-induced hypertension, edema or any kidney problems. But if the patient is not gaining weight or stationary weighting or falling in weight, it may be indicative of IUGR. Weight gain and nutrition during pregnancy directly proportional to the fetus weight gain. Adequate protein intake is essential for meeting the demands of the pregnancy. BMR increase up to 30% higher depending upon the pre-pregnant health status. Hematological changes. The blood volume increases to 40 to 50% by 30 to 32 weeks of gestation. By 10th or to 12th week starts to increase and reaches maximum by 32 weeks. The plasma volume will be increased to 50%. RBC and hemoglobin increase up to 20 to 30%. This disproportionate increase between the plasma volume and the hemoglobin will lead to the hemodilution, and this lead to physiological anemia. The reason for the physiological anemia is the disproportionate increase in the plasma volume. The plasma volume has been increased to 50%, but RBC has increased only up to 30%. So this disproportionate increase in the plasma volume and the hemoglobin will lead to the physiological anemia. Increased blood volume. Why there is an increase, so much of increasing the blood volume? This is to transport the nutrients and oxygen to the placenta where they are available for the growing fetus and to meet the demand of the expanded maternal tissue in the uterus and the breast. 5 major changes in the blood flow occur during the pregnancy. 5 major changes. The blood flow altered into the uteroplasminal unit. About 500 to 600 ml per minute required to perfuse the uterus and the placenta at term. Second, renal plasma blood flow increases up to 75% and to remove the increased metabolic base generated by the mother and the fetus. Woman's skin requires increased circulation due to dissipate the heat generated by increased metabolism during the pregnancy. Blood flow to the breast increases, resulting in engorged and dilated veins. Weight of the expanded uterus on the inferior vena cava and iliac veins partially obstructs blood return from the leg, and blood pools in the deep and superficial veins. It causes stasis of blood and venous distension. Advantage of hemodilution. Because of decrease in the blood viscosity, ensure adequate gas exchange between maternal and fetal circulation, and also it protect mother against the adverse effect of blood loss during the delivery. Total protein increases from 180 gram to 230 gram. 180 gram is the pre-pregnant total protein, but during the term it is increased to 230 gram. Blood coagulation factors. Pregnancy is a hypercoagulable state. All coagulation factors like 1, 7, 8, 9 and 10 increased control blood loss and hemostasis after separation of the placenta. Fibrinolytic decreases during the pregnancy. Platelet count may decrease slightly. The blood compound. Iron absorption and iron binding capacity increase during pregnancy. Iron supplementation is needed for the hemoglobin synthesis and erythrocyte production to prevent iron deficiency anemia. Erythrocyte production increases by 30% with supplementation and 80% without supplementation. Leukocyte increases during pregnancy to 12,000 to 15,000 cells per millimeter, cubic millimeter. Metabolic changes. There are metabolic changes. It is to increase the need of the meat-dying fetus. Protein metabolism. A positive nitrogen balance throughout the pregnancy is maintained. At term, the fetus and placenta contain about nearly 500 grams of protein. Breakdown of amino acid to urea is suppressed. The blood urea levels falls to 15 to 20%. Pregnancy is an anabolic state. Carbohydrate metabolism. Insulin secretions increase. Increased transfer of glucose to the baby. The hypertrophy and hyperplasia of beta cells sensitivity to increase insulin receptor decreases, especially at term. GFR, glomerular filtration rate of glucose increase to exceed the tubular reabsorption. So, glycosuria can be seen in 50% of the pregnant cases. Fat, an average of 3 to 4 kg of fat stored during pregnancy, especially at abdominal wall, breast, hip and thigh. HDL increases by 15% and LDL is utilized for placental steroid synthesis. Iron is actively transported to the placenta. Iron requirement during pregnancy is 1 gram or 1000 milligram. For the fetus and placenta, 30 milligram. Increase RBC 400 milligram. 200 milligram loss in the normal route. Iron requirement more in the third trimester. And the calcium metabolism. Increase demands of calcium by growing fetus by 28 gram. The 80% of which in third trimester, daily requirement during pregnancy is 1 to 1.5 gram. The absorption, calcium absorption from the kidney is increased due to increased level of 1,25-dihydroxyvitamin D3. Calcitonin level increased 20%. It protects maternal skeleton from osteoporosis. Systemic changes. Respiratory system. Elevation of diaphragm by 4 cm at term. So, hypoventilation causes change in acid-base balance. There is a slight increase in the pH indicate that pregnancy is a state of compensatory respiratory alkalosis. These changes facilitate the transport of carbon dioxide from the fetus and transport oxygen release from the mother to the baby. Oxygen consumption rises to 20 to 40% to provide increased demand of the mother and the baby. For this, progesterone causes hyperventilation slightly by deep breathing, and this causes rise in the tidal volume 30 to 40%. Second is the urinary system. Dilatation of the ureter and renal pelvis occurs. Renal plasma blood flow increases by 50 to 70%. GFR increased by 50% throughout pregnancy. The bladder. There will be marked congestion and hypertrophy of the muscles of the wall occurs. Urinary frequency results initially from the increased bladder sensitivity and later from compression of the bladder. Capacity of the kidney to excrete water during the early weeks of pregnancy than in later months. The pooling of fluid in the legs in the later part of the pregnancy decreases renal blood flow and GFR, that is which may lead to physiological edema. Normally, kidney reabsorbs almost all of the glucose and other nutrients from the plasma filtrate. In pregnancy, tubular reabsorption of glucose is impaired so that glycosuria occurs. Proteinuria does not occur in normal pregnancy. Stagnated urine is an excellent medium for growth and multiplication of microorganisms. In addition, the urine of a pregnant woman contains more nutrients, including glucose, thereby increasing pH. This makes pregnant women most susceptible for urinary tract infection. Gastrointestinal system. The gums become congested and spongy and may tend to bleed because of the estrogen cause hyperemia. Muscle tone and mobility of the entire GIT tract decrease due to the high progesterone level because progesterone is a smooth muscle relaxation. Cardiac sphincter relax and regurgitation of acid gastric content into esophagus may produce esophagitis and heartburn. Decreased gut mobility. It helps in the maximum absorption of the nutrients from the gut, but this will lead to constipation and exacerbate the hemorrhoids due to relaxing effect of the progesterone. Nausea and vomiting. It is because of the high HCG human chorionic gonadotropin level during the early pregnancy. Increased salivation, otherwise thylism. This is a stimulation of salivary gland by ingestion of the starch. Delayed gastric emptying helps the maximum absorption of the nutrients. Delayed emptying will lead to slow emptying, increased stomach acidity, and it can may lead to heartburn. Appetite, pica. Pica towards the food substance is normal and there is no harm for the patient. But it is unfood subjects or harmful food like chalk, mud and all, it has to be treated. Fourth one is liver and gallbladder. Although no histological change, functions may be depressed. Functional change may occur due to the effect of progesterone. That is, serum alkaline phosphatase rise to 2 to 4 times. Serum albumin and total protein falls gradually. Gallbladder become hypertonic and emptying time prolonged. Bile become thicker and cholesterol crystals may be retained. Reduced gallbladder tone leads to retained bile salt and it may lead to itching. Nervous system. Compression of the median nerve underneath the carpal ligament over the wrist joint leading to the pain and paresthesia in the hands and arm, which is known as the carpal tunnel syndrome. Tension headache also is common during the pregnancy. Skeletal changes. Relaxation of the pelvic ligaments and muscles occur because of influence of estrogen and relaxin, maximum during the last weeks of pregnancy. The symphysis pubis widens by 4 mm by 32 weeks of gestation. Increased mobility of the pelvic joint facilitates the vaginal delivery. Post of a pregnant woman alters to compensate for enlarging uterus anteriorly. The woman lean backward to exaggerating the normal lumbar curvature causing progressive lordosis. Endocrine system. The first one is placental hormone. Placental hormones are the estrogen and progesterone which lead to the breast changes, skin pigmentation and uterine enlargement. Chorionic gonadotropin, immunological pregnancy test, immunosuppressive activity stimulate both adrenal and placental steroidogenesis. Human placental lactogen antagonizes insulin action stimulate the growth of the breast. The first one is pituitary gland. The production of follicle stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone stop due to high estrogen and progesterone. increased production of growth hormone. The serum prolactin produced by anterior pituitary gland, later pregnancy, post-posterior pituitary produce oxytocin, but the action is inhibited by progesterone. Oxytocin also stimulates milk ejection reflex after the childbirth. Thyroid and parathyroid gland enlarges to the thyroid gland enlarges to the extent of BMR to 20%. Early in pregnancy, T4 rises along with corresponding increase in thyroxine binding globulin. Both T3 and T4 cross the placenta. Thyroid hormones are necessary for the development of fetal CNS because fetus does not synthesize thyroid hormone till 12th week of gestation. If sufficient supply of iodine not present, goiter, that is thyroid hypertrophy, can occur. Parathyroid gland, which is necessary for the calcium metabolism, will increase in size during the pregnancy because of the calcium is important for the fetal growth. Adrenal gland activity increase in pregnancy as increased level of corticosteroids and aldosterone are produced. Cortisol regulates carbohydrate and protein metabolism. Aldosterone regulates the absorption of sodium from distal tubules of the kidney. Pancreas increased production of insulin. Corpus luteum, the yellow body left on the surface of the ovary and formed from the remains of graafian follicle after the discharge of ovum, that is known as the corpus luteum. If it retrogrades, the menstruation occurs, and if it persists for several months, if the pregnancy supervenes, it secretes 40 mg of progesterone per day. After the implantation, HCG and possibly HPL secretion by syncytia trophoblast cells maintain the growth and function of corpus luteum. At 6 to 8 weeks, transfer of functions from the corpus luteum to the placenta occurs. Placental endocrinology. By 6 to 8 weeks, transfer of functions of corpus luteum to the placenta. Hormones of the placenta. There are two types of hormones. One is the protein hormones, that means the human chorionic gonadotropin or HCG, human placental lactogen or HPL, and second group of hormones is known as the steroid hormones. They are the estrogen and progesterone. Human chorionic gonadotropin, it is a glycoprotein, chemically and functionally similar to the luteinizing hormone. Placental GnRH have the control over the HCG formation. The main functions include, it acts as a stimulus for secretion of progesterone, it stimulates leading cells of male fetus to produce testosterone, it has an immunosuppressive activity, and also it stimulates maternal thyroid gland. Levels of HCG, half-life is 24 hours. By radioimmunoassay, it can be detected in the serum or urine as early as 8 to 9 days following ovulation. Blood and urine values reaches the maximum between 60 to 70 days of pregnancy. Concentration falls slowly, reaching the low levels between 100 to 130 days. Then the level remains constant with a slight increase in 32 weeks. The high levels of HCG in multiple pregnancy, hereditary form mold, choriocarcinoma, pregnancy with the Down syndrome babies. HCG disappear after 2 weeks following the pregnancy. Second group of hormone is known as the human placental lactogen. It is chemically and immunologically similar to pituitary growth hormone and prolactin, which is first detected in the 5th week. Level rises from 5 microgram per ml to 25 microgram per ml under 36 weeks. Plasma concentration proportional to the placental mass. Estrogen, the site of production is syncytia trophoblast. It is first detected by 9 weeks. 9 weeks it will be 0.05 nanogram and gradually increase to 30 nanogram a term. Low estriol in case of fetal death, fetal anomalies and hereditary form mold. Functions of estrogen. Estrogen causes hypertrophy and hyperplasia of the uterine myometrium, thus it helps in the enhancement of uterine growth. Second, hypertrophy and proliferation of breast ducts and glands for the preparation of the breastfeeding. Estrogen sensitizes the myometrium to oxytocin and prostaglandin, so it ripens the cervix. Hyperpigmentation and vascular changes in the skin increase activity of salivary gland and hyperemia of the gums and nasal mucous membrane. The second hormone is progesterone. The average levels of plasma progesterone at 12th week 25 nanogram, 28th week 8 nanogram, at term it is 300 nanogram. Low progesterone in case of ectopic pregnancy, abortion. High levels in case of hydrodiform mole and Rh isoimmunization. After delivery, the plasma progesterone decreases rapidly and not detectable after 24 weeks. The functions of progesterone: maintaining the endometrial layer for implantation of the fertilized ovum, preventing spontaneous abortion by relaxing the smooth muscles of the uterus, helping to prevent tissue rejection of the fetus, stimulating the development of lobes and lobules in the breast, facilitating the deposit of maternal fat stores to provide reserved energy for pregnancy and lactation, relaxing the smooth muscles of the uterus and other smooth muscles, increase the respiratory sensitivity to carbon dioxide, stimulating the ventilation, and suppressing the immunological response, preventing the rejection of the fetus. Diagnostic value of the placental hormones. Diagnosis of pregnancy, it is and follow-up of trophoblastic tumors, detection of function of beta placental unit. Diagnosis of pregnancy in the first trimester, amenorrhea, which is a placental sign, morning sickness, frequency of maturation in the early pregnancy, frequency of maturation will be there because of the enlarging uterus will compress the bladder, so bladder capacity will be reduced, so patient will be having frequency of maturation. Then breast discomfort and fatigue. The objective signs include breast changes, which is valuable for a primary mother, Jacquemus sign, Osiander signs, and Goodell signs, and Hegar signs. Then endocrine, HCG in the urine 2 to 3 weeks, and blood in the blood 2 days after the missing period. USG, uterine sac can be visible by 29 to 35 days. Embryonic movement by 7 weeks, and fetal heart sound can be heard by ultrasound by 10th week. Second trimester, quickening. Quickening is the first fetal movement felt by the mother. Progressive abdominal growth, palpation of fetal parts by 20th week, active fetal movements after 20th week. Colasma, otherwise known as the mask of pregnancy, which is due to the increasing melanocyte hormones. And the breast changes, there can be secondary areola, Montgomery tubercles, and colostrum can be expelled from the breast of the person. Abdominal examination, inspections, linea nigra, stria gravidarum, and the palpation fundus is a progressive increase in the fundal height, Braxton's contraction, and active fetal movements. Then third trimester, again the amenorrhea, enlargement of abdomen, lightening means after 36 weeks, the lower uterine segment will be expanding and the presenting part seeing inside the uterus. So the discomfort which is felt by the mother for the respiration or the shortness of breath will be relieved. That is known as the lightening. Frequency of maturation again develops because of the again this presenting part will be inside the pelvic and it will be compressing the uterus in the bladder. Active fetal movements, cutaneous changes, uterine shape from the cylindrical to spherical, fundal height will be increasing, fetal movements actively can be visible to the observer, palpation of fetal parts, FHS can be heard by the stethoscope, and USG findings. So these are there are three signs, possible, probable, and positive. Possible means presumptive signs. First one is early breast changes, which will be occur 3 to 4 weeks. It can be because of when the person using contraceptive pills. Second one is amenorrhea. The time of occurrence be 4 weeks. There are differential diagnosed by during the hormonal imbalance, emotional stress or illness. Morning sickness, which will be seen between 4 to 14 weeks. But it can be seen in case of GI disorders, pyrexial illness and cerebral irritation. Bladder irritability can be 6 to 12 weeks. It can be seen in case of UTI and pelvic tumors. And quickening is the first fetal movement felt by the mother. It is for a primary patient, it can be heard, it can be felt by 16 to 20 weeks. And probable signs include presence of HCG in the blood, urine, and it can be also in case of hydrodiform or choriocarcinoma, and softened isthmus, bluing of the Jacquemus, vagina, pulsation of the fornix, that is the Osiander sign, which can be differential diagnosis, the pelvic congestion and the uterine growth, if there is any uterine tumors, and Braxton's contraction and ballotment of uterus. Next is the positive signs. There is no differential diagnosis, visualization of fetus by X-ray, ultrasound, FHS by ultrasound, fetal stethoscope. Fetal movements are palpable and visible by 22 weeks till late pregnancy. And there is no differential diagnosis for this. So far we have seen the physiological changes which takes place during the labor.